Okay, so for initial test footage, I'm starting with something simple. I'm going to start with Risk of Rain. It's simple, low-spec game, so I don't have to worry about frame rates or anything dipping while I'm recording. Should be recording everything properly. Okay, let's go. I'm going to edit everything together afterwards. I'm going to remove the noise from the background. See, I'm playing here as Handy. Is a robot. The robot janitor of the ship somehow manages to hit just as hard as everyone else. Actually, it seems he hits a little bit harder. Yay, the butcher knife. Yeah, rusty blade, but you get the idea. Hammer. Normally he just punches things. Those are called nameless, called hurt. Which is, well, I guess that's happening to me. One of the advantages of Handy is that all its attacks have knockback. Which, when the entire game is based around playing keep away, well, survival is based more on kiting rather than doing a lot of damage and surviving it. Being able to push away everything with your basic attack is very, 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 well, handy. One of the only ones also has a native attack speed steroid. The only person who's like tankier but might do a little bit better as the, one of the other melee classes is Acrid. And that's because Acrid has damage over time, so you can just blast and then run. I'm gonna shut up now and play a little bit more until I die. Edit all the footage together and see how things work. So this is, of course, like the first one I've uploaded, so it's probably going to suck. Where are we to go from here? Rock bottom is up. So interject every now and then to explain things, of course, but just, you know, having extra movement speed is very, very useful in this game, especially at later levels because everything starts running faster than you. So we're in a game where the best survival strategy is to stay just ahead of everything and attack just out of range. You can understand how being able to move faster is useful. For those of you who played Risk of Rain, the idea is that you are stranded in this alien world. We transport you along with a freighter with some cargo and some passengers. You crash land on this alien world, and for some reason everything is trying to kill you. As you go along, you find the items that the cargo of the ship has dropped. Strangely enough, by murdering the shit out of the life forms. See, it's roguelike, so you don't have a save game. But as you go along and accomplish your tasks, unlock new items and new characters. Right now in this playthrough, the only character I'm missing is the miner. Some of them are unlocked pretty much by chance. You unlock them by finding them at certain levels. You only have some levels, you only just use a short small number of levels, which one you get, and then are sort of randomly determined. So, you never know which one you're going to get. So you may or may not even get the level that you want. Things do is they pop out a bunch of your mini wraith things. What's the cost underneath it? Other than that, if you kill all of them within, I think it's 10, 15 seconds. So there's no movement if you walk in a certain way. If you kill them all, you get an item. And of course, each item does certain things. Some items are not better than others, plain and simple. And drones, guys, things following me are very useful. Lovely attack from a distance. Which characters like handy, the only range attack they have is that drone thing. Get the idea. Anyway, as I was saying, the object is you find the teleporter, which takes you to the next level. You go on, you get to the end of it, it goes to get back to the ship, so you can get off the planet. The ship crash landed, get the escape pod. And you're trying to get back to the ship and survive the world. And I'll be right over there. See the difficulty level, which actually increases as the game goes on. The longer you take to do certain things, the higher the difficulty grows, the more enemies spawn, the more difficult the enemies spawn are. So, well, not two Gokus, so that should be well, at least for a little while. Hoping that the portal is down there. Is it? Is it? It is not. Where the fuck is it? Yeah, I'm gonna be sweating a bit. Just so you know. I'm just gonna have my chair just a little bit to stay close to the microphone, just so it's easier for you all to hear me. Stay alive for another 90 seconds, and it spawns a boss, and a whole bunch of enemies. And with most roguelikes of this nature, the items you get are one random chance. Isaac, you know, sometimes you'll find items that are absolutely awesome, and other times you'll find items that are completely useless to you. get that item if I'm lucky. Okay. Power attacks were released in one of these later patches. I haven't actually used them yet because I haven't unlocked any of them. And I've noticed a lot of the game, some of the items are luck based. Where are you? Okay, there's like one dude left. Do this. There we go. Murder the shit out of them. Move on to the next level. Fortunately, your drones don't carry over with you. Well, the handy drones. The other hovering drones there, the ones that shoot at things, those stay with you. Heal myself up. Oh my. And it's a phone call from my girlfriend. So I'm going to pause this and stop recording for now.